Welcome to Catch and Go. It's a blessing to come to you and to deliver the word of the Lord. Let us not waste any time. And now let's continue with my PowerPoint, which is PowerPoint 11, Biochemical Warfare. I want to give you a heads up. And what I want to say to you is, have we now reached the point where we're seeing biochemical warfare in the makings? Or are we getting ready to see where all the nations will now go into a nuclear arm race? I have something in my heart that I want to talk to you really in this telecast, but I'm going to just hold because you're going to need to listen to my title called COVID-19 Revelation 13, and then you will understand why I held and didn't come out and say what I wanted to say. Now, another thing is that on July the 9th, 2021, the Lord said to me, wolves in sheep's clothing, and that a wolf, a face of a wolf appeared to me, and the Lord said, now he will expose. And prior to that, I saw a man had hanged himself. And what I believe is that the hour of exposure, where God is going to expose so many people, not just in the world, but athletes, sports athletes, celebrities, movie stars, those down in Hollywood, and those in the body of Christ. And then you're going to see that once these people are exposed, and either they're facing incarceration or life in prison, or some are not going to be able to take it because their reputation has been tarnished and their character, they're just simply going to hang themselves. Now, I want to talk about 1 hour, one day. And what I want to say to you is that whatever God's going to do going forward, he's going to do it quickly, as I spoke to you from Revelation 22, verse 12, Revelation 16, verse 15. That's Revelation 16, verse 15, from Revelation 22, verse 12, where it says, behold, I'll come quickly. Jesus, God himself, is going to do this thing and end this whole thing once and for all. Then I want to talk to you about the final visitation on a title called Countdown. There are six parts, I believe, to that title, Countdown. What's in those six parts? One of them is silver and gold. Why you must begin to buy and invest in gold. Another part to the final visitation, which we call final visitation countdown, is 1 hour, one day. Then silver and gold. There are other things to the countdown, which I will give you at some other time and some other telecast. But why do you need to invest in silver and gold? Why? I will explain. One of the reasons when you read this Bible and when you read the Word of God throughout Genesis to Revelation consists of silver and gold. As a matter of fact, in the Old Testament, whatever they purchase with silver and gold. When there are many passages and there are scriptures also in the New that talks about silver and gold, including the man, which you say, that doesn't mean anything. It doesn't make sense, no? The man at the beautiful gate, when they looked at him and said, what? Silver and gold I don't have, but in the name of Jesus, rise up. Well, first of all, that was New Testament. When you look at Genesis 13, Abraham was rich. Now, I basically gave away one of my titles. When you look at Genesis 13, it talks about Abraham was not only rich, but wealthy. And he was wealthy and rich because of what? Silver and gold. And what I'm saying to you, that the only thing that's going to matter going forward is silver and gold. And you need to make sure that you don't let anyone deceive you, because there's so much corruption when it comes to Bitcoin and cryptocurrency and so many things. You're going to have to go to a place where you literally are going to have to buy gold and invest your money in gold. And whether it's gold dingers or gold bars or gold dingers, like they say, and I will encourage you that whatever you have, it's a necklace, a gold necklace, or a gold ring, a gold watch, a bracelet, ankle bracelet, whatever it is, you're going to need to have some kind of gold in your possession. And you're going to say, and then you're going to sit there and say to me, but I don't believe all the stores are going to be like that. I don't believe everything's going to be about whether you have gold or not. I beg you different. It's going to be in all of your life matters. All right. I'm getting a little bit bold now, because I know people will say, oh, no, I don't believe it's just going to be silver and gold. No, that's exactly what it's going to be. Silver and gold. And matter of fact, the Lord reminded me now that when the Queen of the South came to visit Solomon, she blessed Solomon with so many things. The majority of those things was silver and gold. Look, you need to understand why I'm saying that you need to sit down with someone and tell them you want to buy and invest in gold. It's going to be the only thing that matter. Why you think that nations and leaders of this world and world leaders are hogging up and putting away gold? Gold and silver will be the only thing that matters. But I got to keep going. We'll have to explain some more some other time. Now, I did a telecast called God's Warning to Shepherds. God is warning shepherds. And can I simply say something? Being very gracious and very noble with a noble heart. There is no revival. There may be a revival meeting, but there's no revival. We haven't reached the point of harvest time. There is no harvest time. And there is no way we're near to where God will transfer the wealth of the wicked over to the righteous and liberate and cancel when the church doesn't want to hearken to his voice, especially shepherds. He can't cross you over to a new beginning. And God will never cross the church or the saints over until they consecrate themselves before they come into his presence. Like he said to Moses when they were about to cross the Red Sea. He told, tell the people to consecrate themselves before they come into my presence. The same thing he did with Joshua. And what's happening in 2021 with these prophets and these apostles and teachers and evangelists and believers, they're loading up videos talking about the wealth of the wicked will be transferred over now. Now is the moment and harvest time, and we're not there yet. I have said over and over that God is not even halfway cleansing the church, and he can't finish cleansing the church because shepherds are doing their own thing instead of obeying and hearkening to the voice of God and opening up your altars. Now I got to keep going because I'm talking about the coming revolt. Now, what's the purpose of this revolt? What consists of this revolt? Why the greatest global reset, the greatest shift on July 1st, 2021, a plumb line in place on the 7th day of July? 2 days later, God reveals and takes me into the visions and says, look, these are the face of the wolves, and now I'm going to expose the left, and I'm exposing even those in the body of Christ. The problem is we thinking that it's those It's just those down in Washington and those that are on the left. There's so many believers that are living such a crooked life. And you got to tell it like it is. Not being judgmental, not condemning, just hoping that they will turn and awaken from their slumbering ways and from their sleep because they've been napping too long and stuck to their pillows. And God wants is bringing the shaking and awakening, but God cannot cross over until we fully as a nation and fully as a body of Christ obey the Lord. Look, is America in the bubble? Is America in a place called jeopardy where the nation, that the one nation that got consecrated, separated, blessed, and set apart, is it going to come under a curse? Or will we hearken to the cry, into the voice and the cry of the Holy Spirit and the voice of the Father and Son? That will be determined, you know, by who? By you and I. We here in America. And that includes not just the United States of America. That includes the nations. For we are in Matthew 10:35. I hope that everyone sees and take heed to God's warning and to his cry and to his Holy Spirit cry. Now, I have said that God's judgment is going into a whole different level. But can I basically tell you what God showed me July 1st and begin to show me in part? One of the things that God showed me, and this is awesome. This is so good for all of us. That it will be, watch this, write this down. Pastors, teachers, evangelists, apostles, and prophets, born-again believers around the nations, leaders around the world, watch how God does you. And when I say leaders around the world, I'm speaking to leaders in the body of Christ. What's the purpose of the revolt in a time of revolution, where he's revolutionizing everything? Because of the moment when the church is persecuted and the church is scattered, and not only scattered, but it is the moment that in the moment of that revolt, and when that revolt reaches its peak, God then does one thing. Are you ready? I'm going to tell you. It's the turning point. Now, I really don't. I have to tell you this because the Lord just showed me this. And I know many of you, I will be immediately greatly blessed if you speak from this chapter, all right? And I'm going to say to you what the Lord just showed me real quick when I say that part of what God's going to do going in July, August, September, and going forward with the church is that he will raise the bar, bring the church to a new level of authority, a time of elevation, a time of he restructure you completely, and modifies you, and the church is elevated. He cultivates and captivates your soul. But how is this final movement coming? Well, it comes from Joel 2 and 3, flushes the church into the book of Acts, and in the moment where there is a global crisis and they have put so much pressure on believers and on the church and on the saints, God raises up the bar, raises up the standard, and brings about the greatest birthing of from Joel 2 and 3, from Isaiah 40, 31, from Isaiah 35, verse 8 to 10, Highway of Holiness, from Psalms 133, from Acts 2:44, all right, from Genesis 8:22, seed time, harvest time. Where will you get your miracle? Where will you receive your inheritance and your blessing? Where will God turn this thing around? Where will the liberation and cancellation come from? It will come in the moment of the common revolt, when this whole thing will go into a whole different level. And God says, now I will show them that I have reserved I have preserved a remnant of men and women, God-fearing women, speaking on purity and holiness and on righteousness, consecrated together, working together, and one accord. So then, can I tell you what he showed me just now? Can I tell you the vision that he just took me a few seconds ago? When I said that's the turning point, you need to go into the book of Esther. It will become an Esther moment. But it says in the book of Esther there that Esther had to prepare herself. And Esther took 6 months to go out and look for her most beautiful and unique outfit or dress or gown, whatever you want. And it took another 6 months all to get all hooked up before she walked into the king's palace. We are coming, but we're not close there. So don't hype things up. Don't sensationalize things. And I'm really going too deep into things when it comes to the coming revolt. I'm actually already speaking about the coming revolt. And it happens that there in the book of Esther, it says there in the book of Esther, says when Esther's turn came. When Esther's turn came, all right, her, not only when her turn came, it was a prophetic turning point in the life of Esther, Mordecai, and God's people and God's children. And it says there that in Esther, it says when Esther's turn came, all right, things completely broke through. What am I saying? Breakthrough. We're going to come to a point of an Esther moment. We're going to come into a moment of not only just an Esther moment, but we're going to come to a moment where, watch this, that in that turning point, the doors were open, just like the doors were open to Esther when she came into the king's palace. That's why I have said God has a masterpiece. God has set you up for your greatest miracle and your greatest entrance into what? The pearly gates, where you will wine and dine and you will be at the wedding supper drinking from the golden chalice cup. So there will be a moment in this revolt, in the coming revolution, in a time of revolution, where God says, now is an Esther's moment. Now is not only an Esther moment, an turning moment, but now Esther walked into the king's palace, but the church, you and I, walk into what? The pearly gates in each of the streets of gold. Come on, somebody. Somebody need. I really don't want to go so much deep into this because there's so much else I gotta tell you. But because I share that with you because the Lord just took me into that vision. Because when the left and when world leaders set up plots and traps against you and against the church, God raises up the bar, God raises up the standard, and I want to tell you what the Lord said. In the coming revolt, there is a global crash and a global famine. In the global famine and in the global crisis, God does not provide you with a bowl of rice. God enhances and enlightens your soul to see his glory from a different angle. That's why I've been saying that God's calling for wisdom and calling for unity and for prophets to work together. There is no need to apologize, okay? But I can read between the lines of what other men are saying. And look, I have personally nothing against anyone or prophets, but I want to say to prophets this thing, that the Lord will vindicate prophets. I also want to say something very boldly on this telecast of part two of the introduction of the coming revolt. And that is this, that prophets did not get it wrong. And I will explain why. And I will explain when God said the turning, overturn. I will explain. There's going to be a time when I will explain. But the Lord will vindicate the prophets. Now, what I want to say to you is, right now, I saw in the spirit bold white letters. Are you ready to celebrate? The Lord said that in this coming revolt and in this time of revolution, he brings and pour out from Joel 2 his fragrance in this movement, the fragrance of God. He opens up the alabaster jar, and this is what he said. You and I experience, and we go out, and the oil of gladness and the oil of joy, and he will wipe away your tears from Revelation 21 verse 4, and you will experience tears of joy, a jubilee and a joyful shout when Jesus descends with this archangel from 1 Thessalonians 4:16, and we're taken up in glory, and we are catch away to meet the Lord and be with him inside the pearly gates forever. There is an Esther turning point. There is why I said to you that the purpose of this whole July 1st shift, the purpose of him separating, the purpose of Matthew 10:35, the purpose of him saying liberation and cancellation has nothing to do with last year. The purpose of a reunion and celebration is because you're about to be reunited with your loved ones, and we're going to have a celebration. And I just heard the voice of those saying, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. We are very close to seeing the second coming of Christ. And remember what God said in my telecast, my last telecast. He will force the issue. He will force his hand and bring out the lawless one will be revealed. Now, I share a lot more than I wanted to in this introduction, but I have obeyed God to what that vision. Now, what's in that vision? In the vision, Esther had to what? Prepare. What is God saying to the church? God, what is God saying to shepherds? Why is God warning shepherds? Why is God warning prophets? Why is God warning apostles and teachers, evangelists, and born-again believers? Because he is asking you to understand one thing. He's preparing. And he is saying, prepare and be dressed and ready and your lamps burning. Not to be found in Matthew 25, like the 10 virgins. Not to be caught off guard. Not to be deceived. And to know that in this dark world, where it's pitch and dark outside, God elevates you. Where does he elevate you? In the middle of the crisis. In the middle of the revolt. In the middle of the whole, this whole revolution. In this whole times of revolutionary. And where he revolutionizes everything and brings in what? Divine alignment, divine strategy, Genesis 37 to Genesis 15, Proverbs 13, 22, Psalms 2, 8, Psalms 118, verse 17 on down. What am I saying to you? From Psalms chapter 1, Isaiah chapter 1. Can I basically tell you what's going to happen? You're going to go from receiving a double portion to the fat portion, to the sevenfold blessing, to the overflow, to gold dust. Double portion, fat portion, sevenfold, overflow, gold dust. You are about to possess the inheritance of the nation. You are about to possess your inheritance. And all of God's promises are what? Yes and what? Amen. Glory to God. So we got here a masterpiece. And what I've been saying for 2 years is God is simply setting you up. He's got a masterpiece. And he's simply setting up the church. Can I tell you for what? The greatest revival and the greatest movement ever seen before. From the day of Pentecost, Acts 2. From Acts 2:44. From Joel 2 and 3. And the Spirit of God says, that is the meat. The meat and the substance of my strategy and divine plan and divine alignment. From an Esther moment. It was a turning point. And it says when Esther's turn came, Esther had to get what? Prepared. What is God saying to all of us? What is God saying to the shepherds? Prepare the flocks for the third and final crossover. And then what else is God saying? In this moment, which he said to me, rebalancing. So I went and looked up rebalancing in the Webster dictionary. And it means to put back and restore back everything fully in place. Lord, look, God is just now starting to put together the rebalancing moments so that you can experience the brackets of his blessing. Remember I talked about the different levels of his bracket, the different level of the weight of the glory, the Shekinah glory, right? You find yourself at the mercy seat, right? Like the altar of incense, of the ark will be revealed. And the greatest insert to your soul, of course, is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, right? The greatest answer God gives you is this, that he's about to tip the bowl in the prayers of the saints. And all of your prayers will be answered. And your prayers, the Lord opened my eyes and I saw smoke go up. Like he showed me when the ark will be revealed, right? And where I found myself. I just saw smoke go up and the Lord said, your prayers will go up in ascending to his throne, his pavilion, with sweet smelling aroma, with beautiful arms. Glory to God. We're going to come to a point of an Esther moment in the coming revolt. I will explain why Donald J. Trump, I believe that God saw something and he saw that he's more and more effective from the inside than being inside the Oval Office in the White House. And he can work just as effectively, but even more powerful because he's not restricted. Look, you gotta see God's master plan and why he said overturn. It's not that prophets got it wrong. I better not go into the thing of prophets being vindicated by God. I'm trying to explain to people, explain to prophets too, what's God's masterpiece and what's his plan with Donald J. Trump. I will talk about it. And it's better that instead of rooting and cheering on for him to be back reinstated, why don't we just pray and hope? Because listen to what the Lord said. I want to tell you, you saw me stop. He said he is more useful to the master from here than from inside. Sometimes, look, what seems to be God's plan to you, it's not God's plan at all. What you need to understand, your ways are not his ways. Your thoughts are not his thoughts. His thoughts are higher. His plan is a perfect plan, a perfect timing plan. And what I want to say, it's time to understand that we need to focus on God, him alone. This is about him glorifying himself, not Donald J. Trump. Anyway, God has got a masterpiece, and I want to say also that God has been speaking to me four things. One, the word one. Two, he's been speaking to me about His fragrance, not only his fragrance, but speaking about unity and about scattered. Will Jesus find faith on the earth? The Lord said something to me just now. He said, this is the reason why God is asking pastors and leaders with teams to reshuffle your leaders. Look, it's a Joshua Caleb movement. It's an Issachar mandate. It's an Esther moment. It's a third and final crossover. It's liberation and cancellation. But when will liberation and cancellation come? When we hearken to the voice of God, will America be preserved? Will God save America? Will God preserve the White House? Yes, if we obey now. If not, they will continue to build the high places and the altars of Baal and Jezebel. In a moment that you're looking and taking a glimpse at the Nimrod spirit, at all these things, and we need to stand together. I believe in one thing, that I'm so blessed to be an American, and I am so blessed that my God has revealed what's in his heart and in integrity of his heart. His desire is to save and preserve the White House. His desire is to save and preserve the White House and to preserve America as a nation. But America continues to go the opposite way. So what do we need to do, prophets? We need to pray together. It's not about position, how you position yourself better than the other one, or release a word and your word is far better, or there's more revelation to your word and more substance to it. No, it's about working together for the common good. From Acts 2:44. And that's a word from a noble heart to prophets. God will vindicate us. I already gave a little bit about what I was going to say about overturn. And I didn't go into it, but I will explain how God vindicates prophets. Because we didn't miss it. Now, I want to make something very clear. Because when I talked about and we did all those videos last year, Trump, overturn. All right? Overturn. We were the first one. I can boldly say that. And then many came on board. And thousands came on board. And even one of Donald Trump's team came on board. One of his administration, one of his people came on board from his team. And the first one to say this was a spiritual overturn was his lawyer, Sidney Powers. I believe that's her name. Amen. She was the first one that says this is something that it's in God's work. Something that God's in the working of doing. All right? But I believe that the reason there is overturn, I better hold. And I will explain some other time. All right. Now, when do God brings liberation and cancellation and liberates? Very simple. First, we have to humble ourselves and obey God. The second thing is, God just said to me something so powerful, it's not even in my notes. He said, remember that one of my notes that I did give you, that was part of my notes last year, and since 2016-2008, I said, it's a time of what? Seekers and finders. God's gates are open. God's gates are open where? When did they open the gates? He opened the gates in the year of Jubilee 2017, when 50 years later, Israel was celebrating 50 years of being recognized as a state. And also concerning the war of the 1967 war, I believe. And what God is saying, 2017 was the year of Jubilee. When he opened up the gates, Gates from where?
There's so many chapters. Psalms 118, Psalms 92, verse 10 to 15. There's so many things that God is saying to the church. But we have to work together. And remember, the coming mantle, how he revolutionizes the anointing inside of you. And then there's Genesis 37 to 50. This will all happen very quickly because the earth and this world will continue to get darker and darker. But I believe, as the Lord showed me those words in bold white letters, an outpouring of the oil of gladness, the oil of joy, and we're going to dance like David danced. Amen. We're going to dance like David danced. And there's going to be a dancing celebration and praise and worship. Where? Inside the pearly gates. That's why God has got a masterpiece. Anyway, I wanted to share with you the part two, the introduction, part two introduction to the coming revolt. And then I will break everything down. Now remember, as I said, that we need to work together and that eventually God is saying, very simple, prepare. Just like Esther had to prepare herself to come into the king's palace. Prepare your soul, consecrate your soul for the final crossover. May the Lord so richly bless you. Remember to share, to like, to subscribe, to hit on the button to receive our latest telecast. And remember, I catch you on my next telecast of Catch and Go. God bless.